Hi and welcome back to the basement. It's Dan once again. We have two absolutely superb cabinets for review from Barefaced Audio in the UK. Now you were just listening to the Retro 210 on top. I'm going to spend a little bit of time talking about this one and then we'll move down to the Big Twin 2 down at the bottom here. And we'll have a closer look at that in just a moment. Now there's an awful lot to get through as there's more than meets the eye with these cabinets, but certainly I'm going to spend a bit of time talking about what you can see and what you can hear and put a lot more information in the written review. So first of all, what do we have here? Well, I've been following Barefaced for quite a while now. Alex Klaber, who owns the company down in the south of England, has been very visible on base forums talking about speaker cabinet technology for quite a long time. So I've seen from his very early ideas of putting together a speaker cabinet company, right up to what we have for you today. Now, essentially what we have is, I'm just going to call this base cabinets on steroids. I think that's going to be the best way of describing it. Alex is trying to get the very best of components and the very everything everybody needs from a speaker cabinet into one box as much as possible. So here we have the Retro 210. By the name, it's got more of a smoother, classic kind of tone. You heard in the intro, I did some pick work, some slap work, and some finger style, and it delivers a nice kind of rounded tone. There's no tweeter in this particular box, but the speakers themselves are designed to have a little bit more top end in them. The cabinet's ported on one side, and I'm going to talk about the port in just a moment as well. But the speakers, this is very, very interesting. Now, for those who are into, I suppose, cabinet design and know all about dispersion and the likes, will probably understand this maybe better than I, but I'm gonna try and keep it to layman's terms. A 2x10 cabinet arranged vertically is not actually the best design for getting your top-end clarity out to your audience. You can end up with some dispersion problems. So Alex has attempted to sort this problem out by, and you can see that I've got the microphone on just this speaker here. This speaker delivers the top end full range signal and low end, but the one on the right actually doesn't have any top end coming out of it at all. So this, as I say, attempts to clear up some of the problems around a venue where sometimes the bass tone can disappear a little bit or have, I guess, what you could call dead spots. Certainly in this room, it sounds pretty good. It's hard to tell because we haven't got a massive amount of room in here to go and stand 20 feet away to have a listen. But you can actually hear the clarity from one of the speakers, but it still sounds full when you stand in front of it. Round on the right-hand side of the cabinet, hopefully you can see there's a port. Now, we have got something called hybrid resonator technology on board this cabinet, which is a way of tuning the cabinet to have a bump in the upper mid-range, so you get that classic rock kind of sound, but also a lot more control over the low end as well. Alex goes on to say that you can push this cabinet pretty hard before it, what they say, farts out, which is basically where the speakers get to their limits and it starts to sound a bit nasty. And it is a pretty pokey cabinet, actually. Barefaced suggests about 400 watts is going to be your nominal power handling of this speaker. You can get away with using a 100 watt amp, no problem at all. And to be honest, they say that because these speakers are designed for high volume displacement, then you can probably chuck a lot more watts at them as well before they start to complain. Beautiful metal front grille on the front. Also comes available with a cloth front for a more vintage look. There's a little bit of a weight difference there, and I mention that because Barefaced are attempting to keep the weight of cabinets down as much as possible by using clever structured cabinets. Using some bracing inside, which allows you to have a very strong cabinet, but not actually have to use really thick woods to do it. So again, 13 kilos for the cloth front and about 14 kilos for the steel grille on this one. It's a lovely Tolex kind of covering, A nice classic handle on the top as well. Honestly, one hand lift, no problem at all. You'd be laughing with this. Around the back, two connectors. They are the combo type speak-on connectors that allow you to use a quarter inch jack plug as well into the cabinets, and you can daisy chain that off to more than one cabinet. And on that subject, the technical bit, this cabinet is available in a 4-ohm unit. So if you're just running off of a 1 amp, then you're getting your full power into that cabinet. But also, interestingly, a 12-ohm version. Now, there's a reason for this. If you check out the Barefaced website, they also do a 6x10 version of this cabinet as well. Same classic tone in a much bigger form factor. But if you have three of these cabinets stacked up, then actually with the 12-ohm version, you can still run with a 4-ohm cabinet, no problem at all. And it's not, a 4-ohm amplifier, and it's not gonna argue too much about that. So that's gonna be a really modular 6x10 or 4x10 or 2x10. And you can stand it up on end as well for those really, really small gigs when you're having to kind of squeeze into a corner. As I said, I want to put a lot more information about the actual cabinets themselves into the written review. I don't want to sit here like talking too much. I want to move on so you can hear the Big Twin 2 cabinet. Excellent. So we'll do that. We'll get set up and we'll move down and have a closer look at the Big Twin 2 now. Okay, so moving on, this is the Big Twin 2 cabinet from Barefaced Audio. Massively different beast. We had the Retro 10 on top with a more classic, more like rock sound, more rounded sound. And then we have this stonking great PA-alike cabinet down here. It, much like the Retro 210, features custom speakers from Barefaced Audio. Got a couple of 12-inch speakers here, and they are designed for a massive amount of air displacement. They handle lows right down to the subs, all the way up into the upper mids. And then moving up, we have this wide dispersion tweeter as well. The cabinet itself is finished in a Duratex kind of material, a painted on finish rather than the Tolex style covering of the Retro, so a completely different look, but also features the same metal corners for protection as well. So in terms of inside the cabinet, we've got a very complex crossover. Now, with it being set up as we have at the moment, the cabinet is behaving very much like, say, a PA monitor. Absolutely crystal clear, and in fact I've played CDs through this bass cabinet and it sounds absolutely fantastic. Now around the back we've got a control which allows us to attenuate the level of the tweeter. But what's very interesting about this one, unlike some cabinets where you just turn down the tweeter and you're left with what's left coming out of the speakers below, this one actually retunes and you get more of the top end, which would come through the tweeter, being sent down to these lower speakers for a more kind of like classic or smoother sound. So actually you get to tailor the sound of the cabinet from a very pristine hi-fi kind of sound to this, as I said, a smoother, maybe more rock or colored kind of sound, especially useful if you're using distortion, for example. Like the Retro 10, it weighs nothing. I think these things are full of helium. With the steel grill on, we've got a 22.5 kilo cabinet, and that is nothing with the side handles to lift it up with. There's also a handle on the top back edge and a set of wheels as well. So considering we've got 22 kilos of cabinet here, Barefaced has still put wheels on it so you can pull it around like a suitcase around an airport. You know, it is that easy. With the grill front, which is also an option, drops the cabinet down to 21 kilos. But to be honest, if you're really going to notice the difference between 1 kilo, I would go with the steel grill because I prefer a bit more protection than maybe I think I would get from the cloth grill. 1600 watts you can throw at this thing, and as the Retro 10, you could probably throw some more watts at it as well, and it's probably not going to argue too much. As I said, these speakers in this cabinet are custom designed, and they're designed to take a lot of energy. Indeed, the marketing blurb says that these cabinets are able to compete with a 4x12 or 8x10 cabinet. And certainly reviews from other users of the Barefaced kit have said that they are very, very capable. But I'm concentrating on the actual sound quality in this review. Obviously, you can't hear how loud it is in this room. So I did my intro. You had that nice kind of slap work, finger style, pick work. And the cabinet in here sounds so balanced. I hope you can hear that by using decent speakers or some decent earphones. Laptop speakers are probably not going to do this cabinet any justice. Fantastic. Stepping in it, just 33 inches high. It's going to be a nice one cab solution for most gigs. And I like also being a taller cabinet, being arranged in this vertical arrangement, that you can get it through doorways without nipping your knuckles off, and actually having a bit more height means that you're going to be more likely to hear yourself on stage as well. Now, as I said, that's a whistle-stop tour of the Barefaced cabinets. I'm going to put some more information about the actual construction and a bit more about the Barefaced history into the written review. Hopefully, you've enjoyed seeing these, and you're going to want to go out and try these out yourself. Honestly, they are absolutely fantastic, and I'm liking the Big Twin 2 very much indeed. Thanks for checking out this review, and I'll catch up with you again soon.